Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the Flame 2018.2 update videos, we introduced an enhanced UV tracking and shading functionality that you could use with the action projectors. This helps with various texture projection tasks as well as motion graphics type work. In the Flame 2018.3 update, the projector controls underwent a bit of an upgrade in order to accommodate the additional motion vector enhancements as well as support for multiple UV references. So this video will show you how to take the projected texture on a 3D model and track the UVs using the upgraded interface. The rest of the original exercise is still valid in the Flame 2018.2 video covering projectors, UV tracking and shading. This model is courtesy of turbosquid.com. So following the steps from the original video, here you have a 3D bottle that's been textured with diffuse maps and relit with image-based lighting. Now the logo has been projected onto the bottle because it was not part of the original texture and this last-minute change has come in. So we have placed the projection onto the bottle and it lines up with the 3D model at frame 50. You can call this a reference or alignment frame. You could have positioned the projection at any frame, so you would choose the best one that lines it up for you. Now I'll switch to the working camera view with space F4 to take a closer look at the bottle and its projection. As soon as you scrub to any other frame, the projection goes off. This is because the geometry is animated and the projector is static. Now, admittedly, you could use a lot of nodes to link the projection to the animation of the bottle. But that's a lot of clicking and moving around the interface. An easier solution is to scrub to the reference frame again. So this is the alignment frame, or best UV reference for the projection. Double-click the projector for its controls. In the 2018.2 video, the tracking tools were located in the rendering menu. They have now been separated into a new tracking menu. In the rendering menu, you will still find the shading and blending options. But if you switch to the tracking menu, you will see the new tracking interface. The mode is set to motion warp, because the projection will use the UVs of the 3D model to track the projection. The old option called Set UV Reference is now just called Add. This is because you can now add multiple references if you need to blend multiple references together. So click Add. This locks the projection to the UV coordinates of the geometry. When you scrub the time bar, notice how the projection sticks on the model with the rest of the texture. You can still adjust the projection, but it will always be locked to the model's UVs. Now here is a reminder of some of the rules when it comes to projection tracking on 3D models. UV tracking works with 3D models which could be FBX or Alembic based, and the UVs must be continuous throughout the 3D model's animation. If the UVs are variable and change throughout the animation, then UV tracking won't work. Secondly, UV tracking works on image surfaces and extended by cubics. Unfortunately, it doesn't work with 3D shapes and 3D text because their UVs are variable and Flame generates new UVs each frame. The other important rule to mention is that the projection tracking will only work when the 3D object receiving the projection is animated. By that, I mean it has an animated curve, and it's moving in the 3D composite. Please don't forget these rules, because they can catch you out. For motion vector tracking on an image surface, please watch the Motion Warp Tracking series for the Flame 2018.3 update. Now switch back to the result view with F4 to look through the camera, and scrub the time bar. The projection UV tracking will work with still images, as well as moving pictures or animated elements. If you return back to the original UV tracking and shading videos, The example will continue with matchbox shaders, as well as relighting the projection with physical-based rendering and image-based lighting. Don't forget to also check out the other enhancements, workflows, and features to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.